When you look at his painting, he's allowing you to find a path through existence, through the painting, through the work. So there's that sense of self, that sense of meditating, of being really focused on the work, and then that sense of embracing and connecting with the humanity. So there's that wonderful balance between the two. Yeah, it's beautiful.
Shen Wei brings, in a way, is an ability to open up more possibility for the unexpected and for us to be moved in ways that we wouldn't anticipate, whether it's emotionally or visually or intellectually.
The Shen Wei exhibition has been a wonderful opportunity to think about themes like mark making and meditative dreamscapes, as the Pao Center has been working with Lenora Lee and the dancers here locally, and capturing stories and really thinking about what resilience means in their work in Chinatown. And then bringing those stories here inside of this space and thinking about what new things we can create together.
I was born in Boston's Chinatown, right after the repeal of the Chinese Exclusion Act. grew up in a community of Taiwanese immigrants who survived the Chinese Exclusion Act, but Chinatown still retained that flavor of a community in hiding. And I write about what it's like to grow up in a community that had secrets. It was a special time in a certain sense, in that Taiwanese immigrants were suddenly allowed to bring wives because of the War Brides Act. I was one of the children born. But it also meant it was after the Chinese adaptation to the Exclusion Act, which is paper sons. And paper sons means left behind daughters. So I grew up in a street where we were American-born, but we had the shadow of left-behind siblings who were almost always girls, who then grew up under the Chinese Communist Revolution. And I grew up, as most immigrant children, as a translator of a world that my mother could not really talk in.
A lot of the Chinatown community stories that a lot of people don't know about.
I was born in Chinatown. We lived here until I was 11 years old. We actually lived on this street, and we were displaced four times by the time I was 6 years old. And then we finally, my parents bought a house on the other side of Chinatown, and we lived there for 5 years before the hospital bought that house, and we ended up moving out into the suburbs. When we lived on Hudson Street, this was when all of these highways that you see right outside the building were being built. So a lot of Hudson Street was taken by eminent domain.
I guess the major trauma for us was the devastation of Chinatown because of urban renewal. And it happened across the country, apparently, to monuments, important areas. And the erasure of people's histories is one of the ways that you oppress people.
When you look at Chinatown's history, you know, early as the 50s and 60s, you have community being displaced, a commercial center being disrupted with the construction of the Massachusetts Turnpike, which brought people from outside the suburbs into Boston, but didn't really have any benefit to the Chinatown community and the people who lived there. Thank you. there are community members that have been fighting in Chinatown to leave their mark on the city of Boston ever since, you know, going back 50 years. We have housing units that are developed by community-led organizations like Tai Tung Village, such as BCNC, CPA, ACDC, built by community members and are still active today.
My name is Lydia Lowe. I am the executive director of the Chinatown Community Land Trust. What we do is try to find ways to establish community control over land in order to stabilize the community. So we're particularly focused on permanently affordable housing, but also stewardship of other kinds of community shared spaces. So for example, we began an organizing campaign around reclaiming the public land in Chinatown. Another thing we're doing is trying to find opportunities to purchase some of the historic brick row houses that date back to the 1800s and for many generations have been homes to immigrant working class families even before the Chinese settled here.
In some ways, individual actions and marks can paint a story and also make a mark on the larger community, in this case Boston, to make sure that they're heard and that their communities are cared for.